Hi, you're with Chandeep at Goodly once again, and today we're going to talk about that how do you filter a nested table before you expand it. Now, in case you have been working quite often with Power Query, it's not a very rare thing to witness a table, and a table has a column, and the column has nested tables, a table inside of a table. And how do we actually filter those tables before we start to expand them? All right, let's actually start. All right, I'm in the Excel file, and let's just try to set a bit of context first before we start to delve deeper into the problem. The problem that we're trying to solve is that we're trying to filter a table before we expand the table. Now, while we are taking a look at the problem that I have here in Power Query, we'll also understand a few nuances of filtering, and we'll use the same M code to solve the problem. Please take a look. So what I have done is I've built a query that connects to a folder in my data set. So you can see that on my desktop, I have a test folder. In the test folder, I contain three Excel files. So sales one data, sales two data, and sales three data. And every single file produces a binary. Now, if you don't know what a binary simply means a file. If you click on the side of the binary, you're going to take a look at the preview right here, and this is nothing but the file. Now, Power Query reads the data of the file if the data is converted into a table format. So we need a way to be able to convert this Excel file into a table format so that we are able to read the data of that Excel file. In the Excel file, what is going to be the data? The data that is the data of the sheet. So if the Excel file has multiple sheets, it's going to have the name of the sheet and it's going to have the data of the sheet. We use the function excel.workbook to extract the data of that particular Excel file. Right. So I'm just going to create an additional column on the far right here. There is a column that I have created. In that particular column, I have used a simple function called excel.workbook. And let me just actually go to the left here and show you that function. Now, excel.workbook function is asking me for two inputs. The first input is the binary. Binary, nothing means but the file. You can see that I'm saying that, hey, you will find your binaries, which are nothing but files, in the content column, and the content column becomes the first part right here. And then true means promote the headers that of the data of every single sheet. Now, if you don't know excel.workbook and the true trick of promoting the headers, I'm gonna leave a link to one or two videos and you can watch that and understand how this thing actually works. All right, essentially what I'm trying to do with this particular function is take the binary and convert that into a table so that I'm able to read the data of it. If you now take a look at the custom column that we just created, we have been able to produce three tables. And if I preview that table is going to give me a peek into the Excel file that in that Excel file, how many sheets does it have? So my Excel file, the first Excel file, has got four sheets. So toys, cookies, sauce, and jams, this is the name of the sheet. Every single sheet contains some data that we would like to pull. Now, my need is that from all the three Excel files that I have, which are now appearing as tables, from all of these three Excel files, I just want to focus on the toys sheet. So I just want to focus on the toys sheet. Now, generally, the way people are going to achieve this is that they are going to expand this particular column. And once they expand the column, they're going to apply a filter on the name called toys, and that's how they're going to get it done. So take a look, that's what I have also done. So in the next step, I expand this custom column. So I click right here and the custom column is expanded, and every single column that was there in the table is now appearing in front of me. Cool. Now, since I just want to focus on the toy sheet, I can go ahead and apply a filter on the name column and say that, hey, just give me the toys sheet from all the three Excel files that I have, and I have the data of the toy sheet only, and I can take a look at that. Pretty cool. Now, the problem is that once you actually expand this data set, in every single sheet that was expanded could be very, very heavy, and Power Query might just take some time to preview the data to generate the preview. Is there a way that we can actually go ahead and apply a filter to the closed table? I can actually preview the table right here, so I'm able to take a look at the data in a preview. Is there a way then, without expanding this particular table, I'm able to apply a filter on the name column and select only the data point that I would want? Yes, and that's exactly what we are going to do. Before we start to go ahead and start writing the M code, for just a moment, let's take a look at the filtered step that we already have and take a look at the M code that is being generated by the user interface. So in this particular step, which is filtered rows, there are two inputs. So take a look. The M code here is table.selectRows. We are going to use the same function. Table.selectRows is asking you that, hey, which table would you like to filter? So I'm saying that the table that I'd like to filter is expanded column. What is expanded column? Expanded column is the entire name of the previous step, right? In the previous step, the table was a full table, and that's the table, the entire table. This is the table that I'd like to filter. Then this function asks you for the next input, okay, which column would you like to apply the filter? So I'm saying that, hey, I would like to apply the filter on name.one column, and that's this particular column. And in this column, please go in each row and see that if this value is equals to toys or not. If the value is toys, then go ahead and pick it up. If the value is not toys, then just leave that row out of the filter. So two parts again, the name of the table and the column and the value of the column, and then this is preceded by each because that is going to go in every single row and apply the filter. Now let's just go ahead and start to write our M code so that we are able to filter a nested table without opening that. So I'm just going to get rid of the filtered rows. I'm going to get rid of the expanded column and come back to this table, which is as of now nested. It's not opened. It's not expanded yet. And I'm going to apply a filter to this table to make sure that I'm only retaining the toys sheet of that Excel file. Okay, let's just go create a new column. In the new column, I am going to call this as filtered table, and I'm going to write a slight M code right here. Now remember that I'm trying to filter a table, and the function that I'm going to use is again table.selectRows. So table.selectRows. Now if you remember, the table.selectRows, the first part was that which table are you trying to filter? So I'm trying to filter the first table, the second table, and the third table. And all of these three tables are kept in the custom column. So I'm just going to feed the name of the custom column right here. That means in the custom column, you're going to find your tables that I would like to filter. So I'm just going to maybe pull that column right here, and that's the custom column. Now, in this particular table, what is the filter that I'd like to apply? So I would like to apply a filter to the name column and keep the toys value in all of the table values, sheets, whatever that is. Okay, so I'm going to write the each keyword, and I'm going to say that, hey, there is a name column, and in the name column, this should be equals to toys, right? And close the bracket. I think this should work. Maybe I can just surround that in one more bracket. All right. Okay. Now, I have mentioned the name of the column, and I'm saying that the name column, the value in the name column should be equals to toys, and please do that for every single row of the name column, right? Good to go. Click on OK, and I get another column that I created. And if I now peek into this particular table, I'm going to see that I only have the data of the toys sheet. If you take a look at this one as well, only toys, and this one as well, only toys. Now, what I can do is, this step is nothing but the filtering step, and the next step is going to be the expanding step. So what we have been able to do is that we have been able to apply a filter, and now we can actually expand. Earlier, we had the expanding step first and then applying the filter. So I can just go ahead and expand this particular thing and only get the data because I know the filter has been applied, and say okay. And this data that I have received only contains the toys data of that Excel file. All right, while you were gone, I created a tweak in the problem. The problem now is that I don't have just one sheet that I would like to filter of the Excel file. Maybe I have a list of values that I'd like to filter, more than one values that I'd like to filter, and that is going to be dynamic. So here on the left hand side, I have created a simple list. All that I went ahead and did was I created a list by a curly bracket, and in that curly bracket I wrote the values that I would like to filter, and these are nothing but the names of the sheets. So now I would like to apply two filters, one for toys and the other one for sauce. This is a list as of now. This list can also be driven externally from somewhere else. I mean, the user can also supply this particular list, but for now I have manually written the names of the sheets that I would like to extract. And because this is external, I could also change that and affect my query. Now let's just see that in case I would like to take out these two sheets from a nested table, how can we do that? The process is nearly going to be the same, but we just have to make a small modification to the M code. All right, let's just go back. So I'm just going to call this particular list as my list, and let's just move over to the test query that we are writing and go over to the custom function that we have wrote. Now this was the table.selectRows function that we just wrote a while ago, which is where we are searching only for one value, which is the toys value in the name column that we were seeing it as a preview. Now what do I do? Let's just also open the preview on the side. So take a look at the preview and let's just also open this function. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, instead of filtering for one value, I'm instead going to filter for multiple values, which I'm going to fetch it through the list that I have created, which is my list. The objective is that the number of sheets or the names of the sheets mentioned in this list should all get filtered by the function that I'm writing automatically without expanding the table, and then we can expand it. So what do? I write a simple function called list.contains. List.contains, the first part is the name of the list. That means which list are you trying to filter? So I'm trying to filter this particular list, my list that I have created. So I'm just going to write the name of my list, right? And in that list, what value am I trying to match? I'm trying to match every single value of the name column that is right here. That means first go match that. Do you find toys in that list? Do you find cookies in that list? Do you find sauce in that list or jams in that list? It's going to match every single value of this list with every single value of this column, which is the name column, and whatever values remain, it's going to keep those values. Pretty cool. So I'm just going to maybe mention the name of the I'm going to mention the name of the column. And this is pretty good to go. And I have to equate that with a true. That means the list.contains is going to give you a true and false. And I have to say that if this entire list.contains gives you a true, then keep that value. So I just write equals to true in the end. And that's it. I think that should be done. I can close the bracket. And I can say, okay, I again get a table, but this time in that table, I'm not going to have one sheet, but this time two sheets. And these two sheets that I'm extracting is now controlled by an external list that I can anytime change, and I can give it to the user and he should be able to extract the values of the table. Now, pretty cool. What we have been able to do in this video is we have been able to apply a filter to a nested table without even expanding it. You can use this in multiple scenarios, multiple cases, whatever the need might be, and this should actually do good. All right, that's been it. I hope you like this one. If you have any questions around this, please feel free to drop in a comment and I will be glad to reply. In the end, I'd like to give a big shout out about my DAX and my Power Query courses. In case you're starting out with Power BI and you need to build solid fundamentals and then you want to proceed on to solving more complicated problems, I'd highly recommend that you take a look at my courses. It's going to be highly beneficial. Thanks so much, and I'll catch you at the next one. Cheers. Bye.